Hi YouTube, Thibaut Van Damme here with another YouTube video. And for those of you who are not familiar with my channel, I am a singer-songwriter based in Southeast London. And today I'm playing an original song, and I just wrote it, so I want to talk a little bit about it. If you want to skip ahead, mom, then there will be a link in the description, and also a link in the top right corner or left corner with a timestamp, so that way you know where the song begins. So the reason I want to talk about this song is because I did just write it. I made it a challenging song to write. I sort of set up ideas that I wanted to achieve in the songwriting process. And the result is that it doesn't really sound at all like any of the other songs I've really written. And it has come out structurally very different than anything I've ever made. So I want to elaborate on that and talk a little bit more about the inspirations behind it. So one of the reasons why this song was really challenging to make was because it actually came about through writing two songs. And it's not the first time that I've taken two different ideas and just thrown them together to create a thing. But what made this different was basically that I'd written one idea and I found it was kind of a dead end. And then I'd written this other idea that was completely different and I found that that was a bit of a dead end. And then I realized that there was this sort of third theme that sort of emerged that sort of tied these two songs together. And so I decided that I wanted to combine them and then write the rest of the lyrics and the rest of the composition specifically with regards to this third theme. So I wanted to explore that theme both compositionally and lyrically. So the first song that I was going to write was going to be about this person that I have a crush on. And that's because I wrote this nice sort of romantic ditty and I thought this sounds nice. And as I explored it a little bit more, I realized that there are aspects about this person that really make me feel, sort of really remind me of my ex actually. And specifically when we were sort of breaking up, they had this sort of air of disappointment about them, like I'd let them down. And while this person that I'm currently interested in hasn't directed any of that sort of energy towards me, it just sort of got me juxtaposing this feeling of new romance towards them with this feeling of kind of an old romance that sort of is over. And it was sort of contradictory, and it made me reflect on the cyclical and contradictory nature of time. And so I decided to sort of abandon that. And then I explored this new idea in the exact same setting. I basically just came up with a whole new concept where I wanted to sing about being 26 because I thought it was a funny idea. I don't think anyone writes songs about being 26 for a good reason, you know. I think being 26 is, on one hand, inconsequential. You know, they call it our mid-20s, you know, and it's because it's like, oh, 20-something. You're a 20-something. That's the phrase. And I feel that way about it, but then anyone that is 20 and anyone that's not 20 and older, you know, knows that being 20 is an important time in a person's life where large things can happen, big things can happen that could really change the trajectory of my life and where I end up going and what I do and everything else. And I was thinking about this idea a little bit more with specific regards to my career. So I was working a part-time job just before lockdown began, but then I sort of, when I stopped working, you know, obviously I stopped getting paid, and being a musician has not been the most prosperous career that I've had, though I you know, it's a very gratifying experience. I really love writing songs, and it's very satisfying in that way, but yeah, I'm not making a whole lot of money doing it, and because of that, I've been struggling to pay rent, so my landlady has been trying to kick me out, and so I've applied for Universal Credit, and it's been a whole saga, and recently I was speaking with a friend, Robbie, who, hey Robbie, who basically is starting their MBA today. Congratulations. And I think he's been working consistently since he finished his first degree. And I have another friend, Damien, who's been working in finance for, you know, an extended period of time. And he's been making lots of money as far as I know. And so I was thinking about the fact that they're not really dealing with this sort of issue that I am. And, you know, I don't knock being a musician. I actually love doing it. It's just, yeah, you know, it's gotten me thinking a little bit more about this feeling like I've been feeling like I'm not developing, because how do I know that I'm developing if I'm not earning more money or if I'm not promoted and so on? And when I thought about that, I sort of realized that, you know, I am developing, but, you know, that aspect of time and this feeling of timelessness really does exist in my music. In fact, I think it's one of the most valuable assets I have, because it really removes this pressure to create, you know, which ironically allows me to create very freely. So, yeah, but I was thinking about that. And then when that theme of time emerged again, I said, you know what? I want to explore time and I want to combine these two ideas together and explore this feeling of time, you know, in the composition. And then I made it my challenge to make the lyrics sort of address both of these weird things about a romance that hasn't begun, but already feels like it's over. And also this feeling like I'm not going anywhere and that there is no time. So without further ado, I'm going to play this song. I've definitely spent enough time talking about why I wrote this. And anyway, I hope you enjoy it. Let me see if I can center myself in the lyrics in my brain.
We just met, and you feel like my ex. Oh, I want you next to me. But da 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 dum, but da 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 dum, da da dum, da da dum. I'm 26, you know what's next, on benefits, oh, but just not yet, 'cause I can't prove I am myself to the government, so I can rent out this room inside this house. My only lease, I cannot count. I am alone, like everyone else. But there is this spot at the back of my neck, which still burns when I lay in bed, and I think of you and me. I'm 26 and obsolete, unless you're 26, then you're like me. I am not young, you are not old, I just begun, now I am over. This should have been a love song about someone who saved me from me, 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 me. And I guess it was. Whew.
Put myself to sleep. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the song. If you like the song, if you like the spiel, please like and subscribe. It does motivate me. I'm not really looking to get like millions of subscribers, but it does make me feel like what I do is important. And being a musician, it's sometimes difficult to give that to myself. So yeah. But do it only if you want, if you like what I do. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I will make something soon. So ciao for now.